Well, Mo Farah has the knowledge that he's beaten Lagat recently in Monaco. Lagat coming in second, the youngster, the Kenyan, Ataya Coetzee in third. Here's the starting lineup then for the 5,000 metres. Bernard Lagat, a real threat to Farah. Number 1093. Good Ethiopians there as well. The 10,000 metre bronze medalist, Imani Merger. Watch for Isaiah Coetzee, the Kenyan, a youngster, very, very swift. Also Eliud Kipchoge. But Mo Farah for Great Britain. Is this going to be his moment? There he is alongside the New Zealander, Jake Robertson. Farah sure to be tension. He's just got to steady himself. He's got to have his mindset on race tactics. There's the Irishman, Alistair Craig. Good Italian, Mucci. Merger, the 10,000 metres bronze medalist. Lagat could be the big danger. There you see season's best, only fractions behind Mo Farah. And he has set a US record at the age of 36. Galen Rupp, training partner of Farah. And you saw Kuma, another Ethiopian. And as we pan across, Isaiah Coetzee is a danger. And Dejan Gebremeskel as well. There he is with the number 11 on his hip. Here's Shuji, running for Bahrain, Ethiopian-born, Isaiah Coetzee, still a teenager, the Kenyan champion. Very quick, Gebremeskel, a man with a blistering sprint finish. Eliud Kipchoge, a former champion, 2003 in Paris, a silver in Osaka in 2007. Jesús España of Spain, European champion in 2006. Thomas Longasiwa of Kenya, sub 13 minute man. He's a Saudi Arabian, Alhamda, and completing the lineup, Messel of Eritrea. Well, there's Mo Farah. Silver already. Is it now going to be gold?
You know, if Mo's nervous, I think the majority of the distance running fraternity in Britain will be equally nervous, because we've never won a gold medal in the men's events at 5,000 and 10,000 metres. We've said it many, many times. A great history, some outstanding athletes, many silvers and bronzes, but never a gold. But as far as Mo is concerned, there's 12 and a half laps, which is just over 3 miles. He'll tuck himself on the inside, keep out of trouble, running fairly anonymously, and let the likes of Gebremeskel from Ethiopia and others take the lead and take the pressure off him at this stage.
Well, the early leader is Emmanuel Messel of Eritrea. The tallest of the three Ethiopians is Dejan Gebremeskel, who, let me remind you, in New York beat Lagat, and he beat Mo Farah indoors when he finished the race with a lost shoe. Farah just tucked in about sixth place, and there's Aberi Kuma of Ethiopia. And you talk about the toughness of the Ethiopians. Kuma got into a fight at the World Cross Country Championships. Merger's got a reputation for not at all being afraid to use his elbows, and they've gone out with a 63-second first lap.
Yes, interesting to see, just as it was looking as though it might be a bit pedestrian, Kuma, the youngster, went to the front. So what tactics are the trio of Ethiopians going to use to try and unsettle Mo Farah?
Three laps to go.
Three, the biggest laps in Mo's athletics career so far. Three laps when he can become a world champion. Half of Mo's mind will be thinking, when am I going to kick? But also he'll be anticipating potentially a kick from somebody else. His little distance running computer's working overtime, but his legs have that ability. He really is now a world-class athlete. But he's followed by other great, great runners. There's 13 people still in contention. Coetzee, Lagat, Farah, Kuma, all the best athletes, all there, and all of them believe they can win a medal and possibly gold.
And don't forget the name, Dejan Gebremeskel, the man with the sprint finish, the Ethiopian who's just allowing himself just to keep out of trouble. And he's just up on the shoulder, Mucci, of the Italian Mucci, and now moves up towards Galen Rupp, just working his way into slightly closer order. You see the third of the green-shirted Ethiopians at the back of this lead group with the chain swinging around his neck. And there up front, it's Mo Farah alongside Kuma. And Farah now hits the front. Is he going to decide to go from a long way out? Lagat's there. Kovac is there. This is turning into an epic.
Wherever Farah's been, Lagat has been. Two laps to go. And Kuma was almost enticing Mo to take the lead, but the patient Mo Farah has just backed off, which is the right thing to do. It's not a problem being in that position. We've got Galen Rupp coming wide for the Americas. Maybe he'll push it on. He'll be doing Mo a bit of a favour if he does, the guy on the left-hand side.
And look at Gebre Meskel, the Ethiopian, coming wide as well. He's covering any move, and Farah still leads from Kuma. Then comes Lagat, and Rupp now moves onto the shoulder of his training partner, and a 64-second lap, and now it's Farah and Rupp who lead the way, and somebody's gone down. One of the Kenyans has gone down. We'll try and bring you that as soon as we can. Koech is still there. It may be Longasiwa who went down, but Koech, the most dangerous of the Kenyans. It is indeed Longasiwa who went down. Koech avoided that. So too did the Ethiopians. And they'll come up this time to take the bell. And the burn-up is on as the Kenyans take it up.
It is. Namo's decided he's going to keep the lead. He's going to push the other people away. He's making his run for home. But it isn't a sprint, it's a wind-up. And the wind-up... Lagat's still there, but the wind-up might be the best tactic.
300 metres to go. Gebre Meskel, the man with the sprint finish, who's already beaten Farah indoors. He's up there. Koech is there. Lagat back in fifth place. Gebre Meskel going for gold, but Mo Farah on the inside is holding him off at the moment. 57-second lap. Less than 200 metres to go. What a race we have. Merger in third place. And here comes Lagat. Mo into the last 100 metres. Farah's going for gold. Gebre Meskel can't respond. Here comes Lagat. Lagat's coming all the time. He's closing with every stride. But Farah's going to win it. And Mo Farah takes the gold. What a performance from Mo Farah. He kisses the ground in celebration. Silver in the 10,000 metres, and now gold when it mattered in the five. He has produced a quite wonderful run, and what a display of sportsmanship from Bernard Lagat, who pushed him all the way and took the silver. He's the first man to congratulate Mo Farah, who tonight reigned supreme. Mo Farah, he won that there, and just enjoy that. That is a British gold medal, and he's beaten all the best runners in the world. Lagat the silver, Merger the bronze. Fabulous.
We've waited 10 years really for that from Mo, because here he is again, an image that we'll see, a last 100 metres that we'll see often. But Mo won the European Junior 5000 10 years ago. It's right. Taken him a while to get to this point, but isn't it brilliant when he did?
Sonia McLaughlin, it's all yours.
Well, Mo Farah, the first British man to win a global title in a long distance event. How proud are you right now?
I'm very proud, you know. I just can't believe it. It hasn't quite sank in yet, but you know, I came so close in the 10 and I just wanted to do it in the 5K, so it came to the right, to the sprint right at the end.
You wound it up. It was near perfect tactics. Was that the key today?
That was the key. Alberto just told me, do not let anyone pass. Gebre Meskel tried to come past me, and I just had to hold him. And then the last bit, just try and dig in.
You've beaten the great Bernard Lagat. He was the first person to congratulate you on the track side. Did you fear he might be the biggest threat?
Yeah, I knew Bernard, you know, he's come from 1,500 metres going upwards, so I knew it was him and Gebre Meskel and Merger. So I just had to go out there and just try and relax and, you know, just do what I did in the 10K, but try and get it right this time.
You had to move to the States earlier this year to make that sacrifice, to change your training. It means a sacrifice for your family as well, who are here, your daughter Rihanna, your wife Tanya. Tanya, how proud are you as a whole family?
I'm just speechless. I don't know what to say. I'm really happy, obviously very proud, but it was just so nerve-wracking watching that last lap and watching him come down the home straight. It was almost a case of, is it going to be the same as it was last week? But no, it wasn't, so I'm really happy.
You managed to keep the faith in that last stretch, Mo.
Yeah, it was thanks to Alberto, my coach. He just said, believe in yourself and try and dig in. Just try and like make it like you're sprinting rather than just like long stride, and just change gear and just hold it together. Don't lean forward and yeah, and that worked. And I just want to thank everyone who's helped me. And, you know, it's great to have my family behind me. And, you know, I've made a lot of sacrifices and, you know, moving away from home where I was comfortable, you know, relative, everything else. And I'm glad I made that choice because it's working.
It certainly is. There's no doubt about that. You're a man in demand, so I'm going to let you go. But Rihanna, last word to you. How cool is Daddy?
Cool.
Mo Farah is champion of the world. The British fans who've made the long journey celebrate. A happy smile for a face of 2011, and I'm sure one of the great British faces of the Olympic Games.